I'm so mad with you. Cool, rage baiting. All right, there was an article that came out recently from Business Insider talking about Animal Crossing, and basically the person said that this was a baby game for babies. Yeah, there's a lot to unpack there, but before you even look at the article, I want to talk about something known as rage baiting. This is a tactic online where you make something so angry, so as possible, that you get a lot of attention purely because of the warring that ends up happening on your video, article, whatever it is. It helps it. So let's talk about why this works. In the case of Animal Crossing, there was 1.88 million units sold in 3 days. It's a success. It's loved. It has a 91 Metacritic score. That means that it's so loved by critics as well that it beats out some of the greats of game design. So why is this better than actually doing work that says like, hey, this is a good game? What's the point of upsetting a bunch of readers? Well, it has to do partly with algorithms. If you look at a lot of algorithms on YouTube or Twitter or Facebook, they love having a lot of engagement. This is where you click on something, a heart, an angry face, a retweet, whatever it ends up being. These things increase the value of this article on the website. They get more people interacting, increase the watch time or use time, session time on that particular website. So now you have people commenting and talking about it all over the place, and that increases the amount of positivity from the website's point of view about what makes this article good. There's a famous example about this from Logan Paul in 2018, where he did a pretty ridiculous video involving a forest in Japan, and you can look it up if you want. I'm avoiding special words for YouTube's perspective. And in this video, he got so much attention from BBC, from Wired, basically them writing articles about how terrible this video was, YouTube gave it more support. Not because YouTube wanted to support it, but because YouTube has a system in its algorithm that looks for comments, likes, dislikes, interaction, and outward pointing in articles that are like, hey, he's getting a lot of outside attention, bringing lots of people to YouTube. That's a cool thing. When the case was like, oh, that's not exactly what they wanted. Now you can look behind me at this graph talking about rage sharing. This is a bit of research that researched into joy, disgust, sadness, rage, and figuring out which one was best at sharing stuff. Interestingly, and I think kind of excitedly, rage, although is the top, joy is actually just behind it. Sadness and disgust, though, people don't tend to share as much. So we see more examples of things like this in news networks. If you've ever seen how the networks will talk about crazy crime happening in their society or other terrible things, it's because people watch that more. Now there's an absolutely fascinating example of using this. In fact, there's two of them. Number one is a financial reason. So in the case of Business Insider, they make money on advertisements, right? So the more upset they can get people to be, as long as people don't leave from reading Business Insider entirely, they will make more money saying something that like Animal Crossing is for babies and that it's stupid and you shouldn't play it than they would if they wrote anything that wasn't shocking, right? The shocking value of it increases the amount of ad revenue you can make. In fact, you can run a business just doing that. By writing shocking fake news, you can be very successful in getting lots of attention to these channels and then making lots of clicks and ad revenue in ways that the websites are pleased by. In fact, Russia has famously done this. There is a fantastic protest in Texas in 2017 where two Russian-led Facebook pages, one that was talking about the woo Islamization of America and another one saying like immigration's totally cool, both of them were talking about a protest that was happening on the same day. One brought in the bigots, the other one brought in the pro-immigration people, and they protested against each other. The point? Make Americans split up, make them not interact as much. And that worked really well. It's fascinating here too, because I'm part of the problem, right? Here I am talking about Business Insider, and that's okay. It's important to note that rage baiting is effective and it's something that's known, but as people, we can kind of do things to kind of undo it. The first one is if you see an obviously rage baiting thing, like card pops up right now, or this AC situation, it's pretty easy to note what they're doing once you're aware of the effect of being angry online. The second thing, now that we know that it affects us, we can be aware and be more on top of those moments where we're like, oh, I've identified that this makes me angry. And if I feel upset, it's possible that the goal of it is just to get me to share it, not actually to have it be accurate. And third, there's a lot of money in this, so if you want to figure out how to use it, you can be someone like these channels up here. And that's one of the things that's kind of sad about the internet, but also one of the reasons why it's good to know that it exists. Supporting creators on things like Patreon, for example, can help move them away from needing to be as clickbait. So doing subscriptions for various news networks is another way that makes them move away from writing clickbaity style articles and that kind of thing too. It's the process where you don't need to necessarily pick the attention instantly when you're competing with other people that help decrease the amount of rage-inducing thing. And look at this game. Of course it's for babies. It's adorable. It's cute. But also, it's not very childlike. I don't know what baby's gonna look at this and be like, yes, best game ever. I paid off a loan. And if you disagree with me, you should get so mad that you leave some angry comments down below. And, ooh, share it with everybody, because I can't believe I would ever say something so crazy.